After the shock of last week, the sadness has sunk in. Another boxing great is gone, but Emanuel Steward will never be forgotten.
Our legendary trainer to remember with deep fondness on this week's Ringside.
Joining us, long-time commentators Ian Dark and Jim Watt, who called hundreds of fights where Manny outwitted even them. But first, to our historian Bob Mee, who reflects on a well-respected, wonderful and wise boxing man.
Emanuel Steward is already enshrined among the best teachers of boxing this battered old game has ever known. Steward's death at the age of 68 leaves a gap that can never be filled in the corner of world heavyweight champion Vladimir Klitschko, and also in the hearts and minds of those who have known him through his 50 years in the business. Steward was old school, one of the trainers who learned the craft of the sport from the bottom, from his days as a boy in the Brewster Recreation Center in Detroit, right through to the glory years with Thomas Hearns and the Kronk stars of the 80s, and later still with Lennox Lewis. Hearns led a vigil for Steward last week, and Lewis was deeply moved by his passing. Steward was born in West Virginia in 1944. When his parents divorced, he moved with his mother to Detroit, the city with which he would be inextricably linked for the rest of his life. He was a talented enough amateur boxer to win the 1963 National Golden Gloves bantamweight title, but instead of the precarious nature of a professional career, he preferred the security of a steady job as an electrician.
No other Detroiter that I had known of in my life, and I was 18, had ever did that. And so that was my biggest personal moment in boxing. Even having worked with all of the world championship fights and world champions, nothing is bigger than me winning the National Golden Gloves and Tournament of Champions in my personal life to me.
In 1972, he gave that up to coach amateur boxers in the basement of the Kronk Community Center. And in that sweatshop of a gym where the heat was turned up to furnace level, Steward produced champion after champion. The first was his lightweight, Hilmer Kenty, in 1980. But months later, in the Joe Louis Arena, it was Thomas Hearns who captured the imagination of boxing fans around the world with a brutal second-round destruction of Pipino Cuevas. The hitman had arrived.
Everyone expected Tommy Hearns to win the championship first, and I had an opportunity to go make a deal. And I made a deal, and to the big surprise of everyone, Hilmer Kenty, a 10-1 underdog, knocks out a guy named Ernesto España and became the first world champion professionally for Kronk. And 6 months later, Tommy Hearns wins the welterweight championship of the world.
In later years, Steward looked back at the 80s as a time when the best fought the best. Hearns, Roberto Duran, Marvin Hagler, Ray Leonard, Wilfred Benitez, they avoided nobody and consequently gave boxing some of the greatest fights in its history. It saddened him to see the situation today where the best seem to avoid the best and fans don't get the fights they deserve.
We don't have too many really top attractions in boxing today. The fact that everyone is looking forward to this big super fight between Mayweather and Pacquiao, which may or may not ever happen. And beyond that, you say, well, what would be the next big fight that everyone would want to see? There's nothing.
Steward's reputation grew as his talent for adapting fighters, tweaking slightly what they did naturally, and making them more effective became obvious. He did it with Dennis Andres, who lost his light heavyweight crown to Hearns and reacted by traveling from London to the Kronk and asking Emanuel to train him. Andres was transformed and regained his title twice. Later on, Steward brought his knowledge and wisdom to bear on Lennox Lewis. Emanuel was in the corner of Oliver McCall when McCall stopped Lewis in two rounds in 1994, and Lewis subsequently hired him to put matters right. They were together for the rest of Lennox's career. Of course, like any great trainer, Steward needed the material to work with and needed his fighter to be prepared to work with him. Sometimes that just wasn't possible, but he still gave them everything he had.
Don't worry, but you ain't gonna need a fight, but you gotta let punches go. That's
right. He knows.
Wait until they get, if you miss a fight, you go right back. And don't take 30 seconds to start another punch.
Right.
goddamn round with him. He's doing exactly what he said he was going to do, trying to steal the championship. But you got to throw some goddamn punches. You quit going up and down, up and down. Fight. You got 3 minutes, man. You got to fight.
When a boxer knew Steward was in the corner, he knew he was coming back at the end of a round to a man he could trust and respect. That is why Emanuel was in demand to work with the likes of Oscar De La Hoya, Evander Holyfield and Nazim Hamed. Always, however, he stuck with his legacy and his roots. He knew Thomas Hearns should have stopped boxing at the beginning of the 90s, but at the end of that decade, he travelled to Manchester with his old friend to be there for him in a fight with Nate Miller. They worked together at Billy Graham's Phoenix Gym, and the bond was obvious. As a trainer, Steward was always prepared to share his thoughts with the media. And when he became an analyst for HBO, his ability to communicate his old-school wisdom to millions of fans made him a fixture in their team. Steward was respected for his extraordinary professional achievements and loved for his dignity, integrity, and honesty. And none of us can ask for more than that.